Hi there, welcome to the new video. Today we'll be going through this paper, which is titled as DialoGPT, Large-Scale Generative Pre-training for Conversational Response Generation. This is from researchers from Microsoft, and this paper got accepted in ACL 2020 under System Demonstration category. So before starting today's video, I would like to make some announcement. So last week, I did a poll on my community tab addressing the concerns regarding the audio and video production quality. So 71% of you have said yes, but actually didn't mention to what that issue was. So that kind of makes me more confused to what that issue might be. So I would request, if you are one of them who have ticked on yes, then please go ahead and type it in the comment section to what that problem is, so that I can rectify it from the next set of videos that I make. Also, if you are one of them who haven't seen this post, I would encourage you to please visit my community tab and leave your vote for the same. Getting back to the paper. Okay, so this paper talks about using the GPT model for the use case of building conversational bots or chatbots by generating a response in a given conversation during any session. So before that, to all of those who don't know what GPT is, it's a large-scale transformer-based language model that was released by OpenAI. So in this paper, they used a version 2 of this for pre-training it on chat data. So the way GPT works is, it takes in each word at a time, and at the output end, it tries to predict the next word in that sequence by giving attention to all the words that have been happening in the past. So let's say at tth time step, we are at this position. So the model will produce a word that should follow this word by seeing the words that have already occurred in the past. So which means there is a mask that is applied over the attention weights, because of which it can just see things that have happened to its left and cannot peek anything that happens to its right, which is one of the basic differences between BERT and GPT as well. And it keeps producing these next tokens one step at a time till you see some explicit end of the text token from the vocabulary. So yeah, that is a very basic high level idea to what GPT is and how it works. So OpenAI released many versions of this model depending on the layers and the parameters. So researchers in this paper use many of the variations while doing the pre-training step. We'll get to the results of each of them as we proceed forward. But yeah, that was a high level view of what GPT is. Now talking about how GPT can be used in chatbot based scenarios. Let's say you have user 1, then user 2. He types in something, then user 2 types in something. And let's say this happens for k iterations. Now this is the point where your chatbot needs to intervene. So the input to the GPT model would be essentially all the UIs that you see as a big concatenated sequence, and post that it starts generating the words till it sees the end of the sequence token. So yeah, this is the entire idea of this paper, and they have done this pre-training for a lot of sentences and sessions by scraping data from the subreddits. So let's get to the further detail of this by starting with the abstract. So they say, like, we present a tunable neural conversational response generation model, DialoGPT, that was trained on 147 million conversation-like exchanges from Reddit subcomments. So yeah, this is the huge size of the conversational dataset that they use for pre-training their model. And they scrape out the conversation from Reddit comment chains that span from 2005 to 2017. The model attains a performance that is close to humans in both terms of automatic and human evaluation for single-turn dialogue settings. Okay, so talking about single dialogue conversations, so we usually notice multi-turn dialogues and single-turn dialogues in any conversation. So some examples of single-turn dialogue, like a user asks a bot to how's the weather outside, and the bot responds saying it's 42 degrees centigrade. So snippets like these refer to the single-turn dialogue systems, where a bot just responds to the question that is asked at any time and doesn't hold the notion of history to understand what was being talked about before this question was asked. So earlier voice assistants like Amazon Alexa, Google Home were all single-turn dialogue systems, but now more or less they have started to understand a bit of a context and history to do a follow-up conversations. So the second is multi-turn dialogues, example of which is like the way you talk to your friend over WhatsApp, Facebook chat or something, where you ask him certain things, he responds, again you do a follow-up for possibly this one, or maybe you start a new topic, then again he answers to that. So this thread keeps on increasing, where every user U and A gets multiple turns as the conversation progresses forward. So these are two types of conversations that usually happen. Okay, moving forward. They show that conversational systems that leverage DialoGPT generate more relevant, contentful, and context-consistent responses than the strong baseline systems. So chatbots, if they are deployed in a fully automated fashion, usually suffer from generating something like bland responses, repetitive responses, monotonous responses. All of these are a couple of things that come up as a challenge when you do a fully automated chatbot thing. But it looks like DialoGPT generates that is very relevant to the context in which the conversation is happening. It's also contentful, which is a sign like these are not bland enough. Okay, so let's move forward and see the model and the dataset in detail. So the dataset is extracted from Reddit from 2005 to 2017. And if you have used Reddit at some point of time, you'll see like you have a notion of adding title and then adding a question or any comment. And then people can start writing follow-up comments on that. And you can even have a nested structure where people do a comment over another comments. So all sort of those things are possible. So they extract all the intermediate threads that spawn any nesting to their leaf nodes. So in this case, something like this would be extracted, where this will be treated as a head node and this as a leaf node. So this becomes your conversation. So after they are done extracting these segments, now comes the part where they filter out the dataset and removing the instance that are noisy. So they employ a couple of rules to this. So they remove the instance if there is a URL in source or target. So under this section, you can think of source as the yellow color thing that I've highlighted, and the target is the pink color one, because you need to produce this through DialoGPT by seeing all the things that have happened in this particular thread. So if there is a URL in this pink section or maybe in this yellow section, they discard the entire instance. The second rule that they employ is that if the target contains word repetitions of at least 3 words, so removal of any instance using this method would help model not fall into the trap of generating same things again and again within the same sentence and become monotonous and bland over there. So the third rule that they employ is that they remove if the response does not contain at least one of the top 50 most frequent English words. So this looks like a check for the language identification task more or less, because they were only targeting the English language for now. So they wanted to be very sure in terms of whatever they are feeding to the model is of the same language. Okay. The fourth point states like they've removed the response where they see a markup tags such as opening braces and closing, because this would kind of signify like the presence of HTML code and stuff. So they remove those instances as well. So they remove the instances where source plus target sequence crosses more than 200 words. So that is again to kind of limit the long-term dependencies and not let models suffer from this forgetfulness property. So yeah, this is for that. And then they also remove the instances where the target contains any offensive language, which is a basic phrase match that they do from the large block list. So apart from these 6 rules, in addition, they also aggressively filtered out the blandness. Like they removed instances where the response contained 90% of the trigrams that have been seen in more than 1,000 places. So if a sentence has a trigram that is commonly available or occurring at more than 1,000 places, they use this heuristics as a measure of blandness, and they explicitly remove those sentences from the dataset. So after applying all of these filtering methods, now they have a total of 147 million dialogue instances with a total of 1.8 billion words. So this was all the massaging that they did to the dataset with the motivation of keeping it high quality so that the model is able to learn better. Okay, moving forward. So talking about the method, they first concatenate all the dialogue terms in a dialogue session in a very long text like x1 to xn, where n is the length of the sequence. So let's take in session S, where you have like user 1, user 2, then again user 1 response, then user 2, and this keeps on going for n iterations. So if you concatenate all of the UIs till n, you'll get something like U1, U2, U3, till UN, all of this horizontally stacked, which is similar to Xi's, what they're saying, where n is the sequence length. And then you append the end of text token at the end of UN, and then they bifurcate the sequence at certain point M, and all the occurrences of UI before M become your source or the dialogue history, and everything post M plus 1 till N becomes your target. So that's what they have written. S is from X1 to XM and T is from X of M plus 1 to N. Now we want to train a model so that we maximize the probability of generating P of T given X, which means we want a model to be really good enough to predict what the following sequences will be, given I show my model all the occurrences that have occurred in the past. So this can be represented by this equation where you find P of T given X and you produce as a product of probabilities that you give at every time step T for producing any word, and you want to maximize this likelihood. So let's take an example. If M was equal to 2, then this would have been product of N is equal to 3 to N, P of X of 3 given X of 1, X of 2. So which means you would consider previous two utterances and try to produce the next utterance for all the sentences till end. And similarly, this right hand side keeps on increasing for the model to give it more context to produce the next sentence. So in the sense of GPT, you can think of this as, let's say m was equal to 2 and you have x1 and x2. This goes to GPT model and it starts producing the first word of x3. And this keeps going till you produce the end of the text token, that is at the end of xn. So the loss would be calculated on the targets and not on the sources. So this is again a tunable parameter to how many source do you want to consider beforehand. So the aim for the model is to produce a skewed probability distribution at every time step t, so that it represents the values that are close enough to the actual input. And then you multiply all of these values to get the likelihood. So yeah, moving forward.
So authors also implement a backward model to rank the sentences that model generates. So this is also a GPT-2 based model that takes in the target that you have generated and tries to produce the source sentence. So this is just the opposite of the model that we have just trained. So the ranking of the target is required because they are utilizing top K sampling strategy at every time step T for getting the words out of the language model. So the way top K sampling is, after you get a softmax distribution at any time step T, you select some value of K, let it be let's say 30. Then you sample top 30 words based on that distribution, and then you sample a random word from there. And you keep doing this till the end of the text token is reached. So now the higher the value of K, this gives model more freedom in terms of choosing the words and getting diverse outputs. But it is very likely that not all the outputs would make a lot of sense. So some method has to be there that kind of scores every sentence that you generate, which in this case is this model. So the way the entire thing works now is like this. Let's say our source sentence was just one sentence and we want to generate just one target sentence. Let's call it S and T. So you have one model, which is again a GPT based model, that takes in a source, produces a target, which is like P of T given S. So at this step, you'll be getting TIs essentially because of the stochastic top K sampling strategy. So for each of the TIs, you pass it to a reverse GPT model that was trained to get P of S given T. So when this T1 goes to this model, it produces S1, then this produces S2, and similarly you'll be getting till SI. Now our GPT would have incurred a loss while it was producing S1, or in other terms, it would have calculated a likelihood for this S1, S2 till SI. You choose the source that has the maximum likelihood, which in turn tells you that the corresponding TI was good enough to generate this sample SI. So all of this kind of maximizes the mutual information between the target and the source sentences and helps the model to remain context sensitive and not produce some bland and repetitive outputs. Because if that would have been the case, the RGPT would give you a higher loss or the lower likelihood in that sense. So now they have experiments and all. So we are done with the paper now. So if you like this video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Also make sure you share this video across with your friends. I'll meet you in the next one. Bye.